Gotta go find some rims. This drop axle. Let's see what we got in our supply back here. I need to mow the grass. Alright, so I got back here. What do I got for rims? This drop axle. A aluminum over there. It's not a super single, is it? Oh, is that a super single? Yeah, it is. Maybe that one. Oh, that's the one split ring. I wonder if that's where this. Okay. All right. That probably was the old room right there. Not sure if I'm right or wrong, but I believe you can just replace these split rings with like normal rimmed ones. I do have two here. Might try to throw those on. I mean, don't get me wrong, these are split rings, and this is probably what came on that trailer. Because I think that's where I got these. Our new trucks don't have any of this stuff. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna grab those ones, wheels in, and see if those fit on. And if they fit, awesome, we'll throw them on. Cool. These look like they're pretty domed out too. I'm not a rim expert, but looks like, I don't know, most of the ones there aren't like that. Oh, that was on. That's a normal rim. I don't know. We may have to make a phone call here quick and see if I can put those on here or not. These are dished. I know there's a difference between hub pilot and whatever. I'll try that out. Here we go.
No fit.
To be.
By the way, you guys are all just on camera.
What the fuck? What are you doing over there?
I keep up
with it. No consent.
Jesus Christ.
God.
So now we need a harmonic balancer, put this back on the fucking stand, take the flywheel off, take the back cover off, get this up.
Got a fucking battle wound.
Hello, Chris.
I'm just happy we got the white kit hooked up. You think it's gonna run, right?
Absolutely not. Like, you want this thing to run? Fuck. Are you looking at who's rebuilding it?
Yeah, this thing's
toast. This thing's fucked.
That sucks. I should have had cameras on you guys when you started.
Yeah, now you literally have, like, this.
Think how many people out there that would love to see an LS rebuild. Like a backyard LS rebuild fucking.
Now we gotta get fucking oil back on this before the fucking cylinder walls rust out.
That's true, we ain't gonna coat them.
A little diesel oil?
Sure, a little diesel oil.
A little diesel oil.
Well, I'm all right. I'm just glad we got this thing hooked up. Too bad we have to cap that quick down. I'll get quick down on this thing eventually. Just need to put a freaking hose and a wire and a pipe.
Or if Dwayne would do that for us, weld another pipe in here over the weekend.
I got the hazards on, marker lights on.
Wow. It all works, but one light. Got one light burned out. That is not bad. One light. All the other markers work.
I can't really see that one. The one in the top corner is working good. Maybe for an old junk trailer, it actually works pretty good.
Well, maybe sharpen the light bars then. Yeah, I just finished about half of that, so you have to do it again. Hey, Far. Why are you so big and strong? You understand every time you swear I have to censor it out? This is Anthony's section of the video. It was beep, 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 beep.
Lost my shoe.
Lost your shoe.
Not in four-wheel drive mode.
No. Almost there. Hey. Can we help you? I can help you. I mean, people want to probably see you struggle, but I don't, so. Oh yeah, there she is. All right. Found the right rims. That one's short. Well, good. Let's paint those up. Nice.
Take 10.
Take 10. Should we get take lunch?
Maybe.
Let's take lunch. That's what I got going on here. So for testing purposes, we just hooked this line directly up to there, but there's no quick connect. We can't get it off. We just did that for testing. It's under its own power. Now we got the blocks out. It went up, it went down. I'll have to get a video of it doing that soon. We need to put a quick connect in there. We're gonna cap that one. Unfortunately, we're not gonna use quick down for this week until I get that plug right there installed in the line, and then the pipe welded in, all that other stuff. That's gonna be a different video about getting the quick connect to work. It works the way it is. It's with single line, it's just slower. So we're coming down, but it's the same going up. So anyways, I need to disconnect this, and then I need to, what do I got here for parts here? So then what I'm gonna have to do is I'm gonna have to put this adapter there, and then I can screw in. Where did I put it now? Oh yeah, right here. And screw this to this adapter right there. Screw those together. And then I can have this fitting right here. I can undo that, or I can use that new one over there. I need to put this onto there, and then the truck will have it mounted. So the thing is, when I got this truck, I'm trying to, explain what is going on here. Normally on all my trailers, the way I set them up is the hose stays with the trailer. The hose is always with the trailer, right? So on this one, they put the hose on the truck, which is fine. But it just, when sometimes we're not pulling these trailers, they get in the way, it gets fussy, and then you're trying to hang everything up here. But it's almost better if the hose just stays with the trailer. So we're just going to put this. It'll be a nice little fitting. Sticks out there. Then we can just hook the hose to it when we need it. And then the hose stays with the trailer when we need it. So I think what I'm going to do is we'll get some pipe goop, goop that together, and then get these all, this fitting all put together onto that. And then I'll have to lift the trailer down, because right now this is holding the weight. The cylinder is up and it's holding the weight. It's as high as we can get it in our shop here. I need to let down and relieve the pressure so it doesn't leak all over the floor. And then after that, I'll put that on there, put the end on that end, pipes all that together, let it sit dry for a couple hours here, and then it should be all good to go. But that's what I got going on. It's always something on this truck. But yeah, I really like the progress we're making though. And then after that, then we got to go inside the truck this afternoon. I got all this cable and I got some glad hands over there, and we need to make some wires and stuff to run all this accessory stuff. But we're getting close. We're getting really, really close. So, and hopefully at the end of the video, I'd like to get this thing to the tire shop and get it dropped off tonight, get some tires on. We're experimenting with this rim, but the rim is not the right, whatever style of rim. I thought it was, it's not. We looked at it, we looked at it again. I had my dad come look at it, and it's not right. So we found the rims we needed. We loaded them up in the back of the dually. You saw Anthony do that. So we take it to the tire shop, get new tires put on that. Get tires put on these inner ones here, the outer ones. Get this ready to rock. And after that, we got the lights working, hoist working, get new tires on it, make sure the drop axle works. And then after that, the only thing left, we got to weld that and then get this all cleaned up a little better. We need to figure out a better way to do this rod. But we're getting there. I mean, she's gonna be pulling here soon. But, okay, I'm gonna grab those fittings over there and then get going on the pipe thread and get rocking and rolling. Here we go. Thank you.
huge mess.
The wrong thread. Oh, no way. Went down, made all that mess. Oh, my God. All that mess, and that's the wrong. That's the wrong one. God dang it.
Yeah, I love the bolts, but we can fucking
yeah, replace both the bulkheads. They're all rusty on the backside or corroded.
We can help each other, okay?
Here I am. Helping you.
And I just beat him with a sludge back in and put the new bulkheads on. I put new glad hands on, and it has all new glad hands.
And blue. Wait, are you using those?
No, I'm just gonna take this off. Have me some fucking wrench on there.
That's a big one. Where's Dave?
Hand me that fucking wrench.
I ain't gonna fit it.
Okay, so now we got this 3/8. One's 3/8 and one is a quarter. And we have to go through that piece of metal that Anthony just drilled out so we can put those coiled airlines on it that go to the trailer. So we need like the 3/8 and the quarter inch fitting. Go through two little bulkheads or whatever they got to get through the metal, and then two those blue and red, whatever you're trying to grab there, the blue and red air supply lines. All right, let me know if you have any questions.
Okay.
Hey guys, today a ton of work got done on this thing. We're not done, we're working on it. But it's getting closer. So in the cab, this is what I got going on. I gotta add one more switch here for the other line we're adding. This line runs our tailgate. That's working good. Gotta get this cleaned up. We had so many air fittings, so much holes to drill. As you've seen, we ran all that stuff underneath the cab. We came out here. We installed for the tailgate. We installed, drilled a hole, installed a bunk fitting here, an adapter. This cable goes down. And I know it doesn't look like a lot, but a lot had to get done on the front of this trailer. So we had a lot of fittings, a lot of running back and forth to the store. But this is kind of what we had going on up here today. The boys are working really hard up here. So the drop axle needs a regulator. So it only has 40, 60 PSI, depending on how much down pressure you want it to have. So we had this regulator installed last episode. We didn't do anything with it. Now we got power to it, air to it, got it working, got the bags dropping like they're supposed to. These bulkheads were horribly rotten. Just this whole trailer at one time was really rotten. So I got an adapter to line, to 3/8 line, all new line run, all the way to the back of that trailer there, all new lines. So, I guess I shouldn't say all new. The only one we saved is this one. This one they got to replace tomorrow. That's one of the originals, but. So we got brand new bunk fittings on all of them, new lines run, new glad hands, the lights, they all work. So surprising, we didn't do anything to the lights and they all work, it's awesome. The glad hand, new bunk connector, and on there. So yeah, earlier in the video you might have seen our oil mess there. We got the wrong stuff, we had to get some stuff ordered to put a quick connect on there so it can come off. We made a huge mess on the floor. There's so much floor dry underneath this truck right now. But we're getting it. We're picking away at it. So it's all you can do. Just keep on picking. Sorry, it was hard to record. We just had power tools running and we had guys in the shop and guys over there working on that motor and customers coming in and out all day. So I did the best to record throughout the day as we could. Anyways, I did finally go to the store and pick up all new lights, wiring and pigtails for the bars back here. It's like I started that and then keep running into these issues. I guess that's part of every build. This bolt here, right here, this one. On the other side, same way, but the bolt's just a little farther forward. And it's hitting that bar there. I just have it barely on there, like one nut right now. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have to, on the other side, take that nut off of the one over there, either move it back or move it forward so I can get that through there. So I can get those wired up tomorrow. It's all a work in progress. Today has been a big one. I mean, but I am gonna start the truck up after I get all this stuff cleaned off of here. And I'm gonna see if we can get this thing outside tonight. That's my goal. If I can get this thing outside, then we can get rocking and rolling. There's a lot left to do. But as far as that goes, we're waiting for parts for that. We have one more bunk fitting that drill's going into right there. It's gonna go to the, that would be the drop axle is the next one. And then after that, get that one wired up. Need some welding done on those back bars yet. I got it, my welding buddy. Oh, he has aluminum welder. He's going to fix all this up for us. He's waiting for it. You might have seen earlier, we tried to get this tire on. Wrong rim. After talking to a bunch of people and stuff, we had the wrong rims. This is the wrong rim style, so I got to pull this off. We got the right rims. Anthony loaded them up in the back of the pickup. And then after that, we're going to need to take this thing over to the tire shop tomorrow. And hopefully get all tires on it, get all the tires going, and then we got some more stuff to do. I do have a liner for the back of this. The floor's not bad, it's just, it's, you know, it's beat up. This trailer was used for like demo at one time, like knockdown houses. Floor's not bad, it's still pretty thick aluminum here, but I do have a plastic liner for it. Might as well use it. It's just laying around the shop, I'm not using it. So we're gonna put a liner in it tomorrow. We're just gonna lay it in there. Then we have to go weld these little inserts on the inside to tuck the liner down. And then we had to
drill some holes in the floor to bolt it. Really simple. We've done a lot of liners out here, so we'll get that one handled. But I think that's the end of our video today. Thank you for sticking along this build and, you know, I mean, keeping up with the channel. Old Blue's coming together really, really well. And yeah, we actually did have this cab jacked up today. I thought I had my camera rolling and I didn't. So, yeah. Well, let me get this cleaned off and then let's see if we can get this guy out of the shop. Here we go.